Dear students, in this video we are going to discuss about the robots. Okay, what is a robo and what is a robo anatomy, how the joints and links will be there for the application of robots like this. So in the subject elements of mechanical engineering in module 5 we are going to discuss about the advanced manufacturing technologies and the robots. In the previous videos we have seen the NC and CNC machines, what are the milling machines and the operations of everything. Now this robot anatomy, first of all, what do you know? We have seen so many robotics, so structures and all. So what is a robot and how it is going to be worked out, right? Like this we are going to see here. The thing is, so robot is programmable automation system. So whatever we want to do, we can do with the help of a certain sequence of processes. Program is just a sequence of instructions what we are going to give, and now the robots are performed or programmed through the sequence of operations, so that the repeated motions, it will be doing the repeated motions and until the program finishes. So by there are two or three methods of programming also there. By guiding this we can do it. And the definition is, the industrial robot is a general purpose programmable machine which possesses human-like characters and it will do for all the operations in industries, right? So let me see what is the exact definition what we can see for industrial robot. It is a programmable multifunctional manipulator designed for moving the raw materials, parts and the tools for the special devices, etc., for doing some variety of tasks. Okay, now why we need the robots? So robots are needed because reducing the manpower. You know, first thing is when we are using a human manpower for a long period of time, we cannot continuously doing the process without any error. So that is a very very high problem. And the robots will be stronger and it is tireless, accurate and repeatability is possible. So number of times it will work in the same precision and same accurate repeatability is the same work can be done in multiple times without doing any error. So that is the one very important task. And another one is labor savings and the cost. We can reduce it because first the initial investment may be there, but after that continuous production and all, it will reduce the amount expenditure and flexibility whatever it is needed, and it can be used in different environmental conditions. These are all the some important things are there, and we can see these how the robo anatomy is there. So robo anatomy is the body structure, how it will be looking and what are the important parameters it is required. Is one is the first base. So without base, any robot cannot be stand, and a base is required. So in the base column and the links and joints, we are going to use some links and joints. So these links and joints are maybe the joints are used to joint links. That is maybe different types of links we can say, joints we can say, rotary joints, revolving joints, orthogonal joints, okay, linear joints, like different types of joints are there. So it's a mechanical robo is consists of joints and links. The main controller operates the joints to execute the program cycle. We have seen so many components like that is the in industries which can be used for moving the material from one place to another place, and material machines which is used for picking and placing some important components. So for all things we need some, the work has to be done with the help of the links and the joints. So the robo, industrial robo, have 5 or 6 joints, and the manipulator have different types of joints. What we are going to see here is one is a linear type of joint, orthogonal type of joints. So the linear joints which will be used for the translation motion from one position to another, and orthogonal next to rotary motions over there. Rotary motions which can be rotational type and twisting type, revolving type. You can see these different type of rotary motions here. So these are all called rotary type of joints, and the applications, this linear and the rotary type of joints will be used for moving the links. Okay, when the links can be moved to a particular position with the help of the revolving and twisting joints, we can do number of tasks. So that task will be replicated in here in industries. There are so many different tasks like processing, operations, material transfer, and machine loading, and for this assembly and inspection process. So these are the areas where we can use these robots. So in material processing, is normally removal of materials. Okay, we can see the process, removal of materials and removal of our raw materials, and it will be used for making another conversion into a useful product, as well as some other products like castings, weldings. These are all the processing operations where the robots can be used. And the material transfer, so one place to another place, I want to bring the materials, huge heavy type of materials, for that purpose we can use these robots. And loading and unloading, increasing loading and unloading, assembly and inspection, some areas where manual visibility is not possible, there the robots can be used for the assembly section, which can be used for lifting heavy weights. And inspection, it will be used for accurate view of the product. Already if you defined what is that exact requirement, so these robots will check with the components, and it will compare the standards, then it will identify. So this is the process of or the application of robots which is used in this industrial areas. So the processing operations includes welding, arc welding, spot welding, spray painting for vehicles after the assembly portion, paintings also there. So like such other process also there. And transferring system from one place to another, material transfer through pallet trucks, automated guided vehicles, and these are all the things which are used in the industries in between the operations of assembly or forging and blasting, molding, etc. So the process, the material transfer takes place from one process to another process. During that time, these automatic conveyors, these are all the robots which are used over there. So these are processing operation, and another thing is we can use in different applications like military and all. These are all the things we can see in the next video. What is the what are the types of robots which can be used under the physical configuration? We are going to see in the next video.